सदाशिवसमारम्भा शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमा अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ता वन्दे गुरुपरम्परा। I welcome you all with my love and respects. Let us enter into the sutra, today's sutra. All the participants, the NSP should know, this morning satsang, the Pada Puja and satsang is watched by thousands of devotees in hundreds of countries all over the world, and it is drastically increasing thanks to the technology. Our recent video conferencing equipment has made the NTV's clarity more strong, and I'm seriously considering to have a full-fledged studio and satellite channel. Because people are from all over the world, lot of requests are coming, and even some devotees have offered money also to support this project. They are all requesting, Swamiji, let's have a satellite channel. So soon you can expect the announcement. We are working on it. It may take 6 months to 1 year, but soon you can expect the announcement of launching of NTV. I'm seeing all over the world that morning satsang with the master is becoming a culture. And I'm also planning to spend more time with devotees and disciples by giving two satsangs. And not only that, it has a purpose. See, people gathering together and sitting live with me as a purpose. If only knowledge transfer is a purpose, then you don't need to sit live with me. Just I can put it in the YouTube, listen, you'll have the knowledge whenever you want. So we may not need a satellite channel, but when you sit live with me, something more than knowledge transfer happens. The transmission is happening, which is doing so much good for individuals and to the world. That's the reason. Now we are working with a video conferencing facility. We will upgrade this facility itself for 108 cities by March 2nd. That's the first level work. And after that, we'll go for the second level work of launching a satellite TV where people can sit live all over the world every day and listen to the satsang, morning satsang. Today is 101st sutra, Patanjali's Yoga Sutra. In second chapter, 50th verse, pranayama, stop your mind, pranayama, stop your mind to fulfill the breath. Please understand. When you stop the mind, your breathing gets fulfilled. If your mind is interfering with your breathing, it is always unfulfilled. Just yesterday somebody was asking me, Swamiji, I have everything anyone will ask for in the life. But somehow that emptiness, unfulfilled feeling, I don't know what to do. Please understand. If you feel you have everything in the outer world, but still there is an unfulfillment, your breathing is not fulfilled. The first thing you need to fulfill in your life is your breathing. If you fulfill your breathing, everything will be fulfilled in your life, even though you have so many complications in the outer world. If you have not fulfilled your breathing, you will have a deep emptiness, even if everything is fulfilled in the outer world. Please understand. Even if everything is fulfilled in the outer world, you will not feel fulfilled. You will not feel fulfilled. Important thing you need to understand. Even if you don't feel things are right in the outer world, you can experience fulfillment. And one important secret is always outer world follows the inner world. If you think the inner world follows the outer world, you are wrong. Ramakrishna says very beautifully, whatever you make in the inner world only happens in the outer world. Not whatever you make in the outer world, in inner world, no. The fulfillment is always experienced first inner, in the inner world, then that actually expresses itself in the outer world, and outer world situations also fall in place and the fulfillment happens. But unfortunately, ignorant mind starts thinking, if you create fulfillment in the outer world, then it will happen in the inner world. No, it is not. It is not the truth, and it does not happen in that way. Fulfill breathing first. How to fulfill breathing? Let's enter into the sutra and understand what Patanjali has to offer to all of us, the technology of fulfilling the breathing. I tell you, just fulfilling the breathing, your whole inner space can be transformed to fulfillment maybe within 10 to 20 seconds. I can say instant cure for depression, instant cure for any mental disorders. Any mental disorders at any level. I really feel bad for the Western society which is caught with these psychiatric medicines, depression medications. To come out of depression or the psychological sufferings, medicines are the last help. It is so unfortunate they are stuck with medicines because they do not know anything else. I can tell you, these Patanjali's techniques can be an instant cure. Understand? Permanent cure for all kinds of mental disorders at any level. Please understand, when I am uttering all these words, I am talking very responsibly. I know I am addressing some of the major serious issues and problems modern day humanity is facing. So naturally, I won't make casual, irresponsible statements. I'm not a marketing agent for some pharmacy company to make any statement, any advertisement, and sell the product. No. I am here to help the humanity honestly, with all my integrity and honesty. I tell you, these Patanjali's techniques can get any human being out of any mental disorders at any level, at any age, belong to any race, gender, color, country. Whatever words I uttered from the strength of Patanjali's teachings. Now one word I am adding with my own strength, instantly. That word I am adding from my strength. Any human being, any mental disorder can be cured at any level, at any age. This statement I am making with Patanjali's strength. I am adding one word, instantly, from my own strength. I know how to make these techniques work instantly for the modern day human beings. From that strength, I am adding the word instantly. Let me enter into the sutras. Bahyap yantara stamba vrittir deshakala sankhyabi paridrishto paridrishta dirga sukshmaha. Nobody can use so minimal words and not to miss even one small instruction like Patanjali. If you use too minimal words, you will miss some instruction. If you don't miss any instruction, you will be using too much of words. But Patanjali is the ultimate combination of minimal words and never missing single instruction. He is showing his ability to use minimal words and giving all instructions properly in the sutra. Swami Vivekananda translates the sutra as, its modifications are threefold, namely external, internal and motionless. They are regulated by place, time and number, and further they are either long or short. Swami Prabhavananda translates the sutra as, the breath may be stopped externally or internally, or checked in mid-motion, and regulated according to place, time and a fixed number of moments, so that the stoppage is either protracted or brief. Swami Sachidananda translates as, the modifications of life breath are either external, internal or stationary. They are to be regulated by space, time and number and are either long or short. I'll try to translate. I think this whole today's session, I'll just translate this sutra. Because just the translation, you can make at least 100 technique from this translation. 100 pranayama techniques. Still I am not able to get the right word for the pranayama, English word. The close word can be life breath. I'll use the word life breath roughly to translate pranayama. Bahya Abhyantara Stamba Vruddhi Desha Kala Sankhyabihi Paridrishta Dirga Sukshmaha. God. Maybe I'll take 3 days to explain this sutra. Don't bother if you don't understand completely, because you may have to see all 3 sessions together. Only then you will understand. I'll explain the first part today. Bahya Abhyantara Stamba Vrittihi. See, as on now, how you breathe should be understood by you. Your body is like a desert filled with sand. Any air movement happens in your body. See, in the desert, if any air flow, breeze or the wind happens, what will happen? All the dust will be lifted by the air and the whole wind become dusty, full of sand. Same way, ordinary body is filled with so much of biomemory. It's like a desert. If too much of biomemory is there, nobody can live. Any air movement, immediately what happens? In that wind, all this dust is lifted. So the breathing, by its nature, awakens too many thoughts and engrams and makes you restless. Unfulfilled. Now, what is the way that air should not awaken the dust and get contaminated. Either all the sand should become a stone, or it should become ocean. That's the only way. Either all your biomemories should become stone, means dead, once for all. It cannot be awakened by the breeze at all. See, on the huge rocks, if the air flows, what will happen? Neither the sand will be raised, nor the air will be impure. The air will be pure. Very important thing, please understand. The sand and the air, when they mix together, both are corrupted. When the biomemory and your life breath, when they are mixed together, both are corrupted. If breathing happens without provoking thoughts in your inner space, you are enlightened. That is what I call pranayamaha. Breathing happening without provoking thoughts. I'm actually trying to do my breathing in all your bodies. Because now I am breathing without having any thought. No thoughts are provoked in me, but I am breathing. One fortunate thing is, this breathing is contagious. If you sit with this breathing, in my breathing space, slowly, slowly your breathing also catches this. This is what I call becoming ocean. See, if you don't want the air to be contaminated by the sand, either become a rock or become an ocean. Becoming rock means by your own sadhana, unclutching and integrating yourself, so no thought during breathing. That's one method. Second, if you think, no, when can sand become stone? By my practice, or at least be one with the ocean. Just go and become one with the ocean. That's what surrendering to God. So naturally, if you become ocean, the air will not have sand. It will not lift sand. It will not get contaminated. There is a third thing. Neither you need to become rock, nor you need to go and surrender to the ocean. Suddenly, a river will start flowing over you. That is what I call grace, compassion of the master. When the river starts flowing over you, neither without your effort to unclutch, nor your effort to surrender. Even surrender is a kind of effort. Nothing is required. Your breathing has become pure. Master's presence is like a river. When you sit in somebody's breathing space, whose breathing does not create thought in his body, your breathing also changes, and your breathing also stops creating thoughts in your body, in your biomemory. I can see very clearly this prana is going through my nostril, and it is going, taking a turn near my ajna, and whatever portion came in, it is just absorbed and goes all over the body as samana, and whatever amount of air is required to go out so that the pumping can happen, for that reason certain amount of air is sent out. But I am not seeing any difference between the air which goes inside, air which comes outside. Any chemical change, any difference? Usually the science says the air which goes inside has more oxygen, air which comes out has more carbon dioxide. The oxygen is absorbed inside. But I am seeing clearly, at least in my body, chemically I don't see difference between these two. Maybe we'll do some scientific research, because I'm not seeing difference chemically. Only in the level of prana, the process is happening. So whenever the air goes in and comes out without creating any thought, it is pranayamaha. So if you sit in the breathing space of a person who breathes in that way, your breathing also changes, because your biomemory is intelligent. Please understand, if you like somebody's body language, you don't need to learn his body language step by step, word by word. Just like that you will pick up. You will just do what he does. You will just do what he does. Please understand. Body language, which is able to inspire many people's biomemory automatically to follow its expression, is what I call charisma. Charisma has nothing to do with being beautiful or handsome or any measurement. See, some of these celebrities, they don't have what you call as being handsome or beautiful and all that, but their body language is something simply which makes people follow. That is what is charisma. But understand, if you follow somebody's body language who is not complete in himself, you are entering into a most dangerous zone. Do not follow somebody's body language who is not complete. I think the best way to explain the sutra is to give you experience. But for the sake of future and posterity, I will talk about this sutra also, explain also. I'll give you a straight instruction how to breathe without creating a thought. Sit in a very comfortable posture, the first thing. Second, just observe the breathing movement. Whenever you get a thought other than the breathing action, stop the breathing then and there. Whether you are in the process of inhaling or holding or exhaling, whatever may be the cycle happening in you, please understand, the moment you see a thought is happening other than the breathing process, see a thought like, oh, I am inhaling, I am holding, I am exhaling, that is allowed. Any thought other than the breathing process starts, stop the breathing immediately. You will see the thought will disappear. Then again, allow the breathing process. Again, when the thought starts, stop. I can say, this is one of the most powerful pranayama process. Very powerful pranayama process I can give you. Maybe today I'll stop with this one pranayama technique. I'll continue on the same sutra deeper and deeper for next 2-3 days, because this whole thing cannot be translated and given in one session. So the essence of first part of the sutra is, whether the breathing movement is outside or inside or happening, please understand, outside means lungs are empty, air is outside. That is what is I call the outside. Inside means lungs are full, air is inside. That is what I call antara, inside. Between means the air movement is happening. Between the outside and inside, whatever may be the situation, the moment you have a thought, stop it. This can be a very powerful instant technique for pranayama. But I'll give you more and more deeper and deeper techniques in further satsangs. Today I'll stop with this. Maybe you can all just sit for a few minutes. To catch up this breathing without thinking, just sit. Sit in Padmasana or Vajrasana and Samana Mudra. Try to sit in Padmasana. You don't need to do anything. Just sit in Padmasana and Samana Mudra. You don't even need to close your eyes. Like an infection, now you will catch this breathing without thinking. You don't need to try to control your thinking. You just sit. You can even keep your eyes open. You don't need to do any technique. No need for any technique. I'm just going to chant the bija of prana. Prana bija is yam. Yam is the bija of the pranic energy. The air energy. Vayudeva. Let the prana, without thinking, happen in all of you. Let the breathing, without thinking, happen in all of you. Remember only the breathing action happening in you. Inhaling is happening. Exhaling is happening. Holding is happening. Just breathing action. Yum. Thoughts are dust, breathing is breeze. Let your body have breeze without dust. Let it have breeze without dust. Let your breathing be without thinking. Let the pure energy rotate in you as breathing. Let the pure energy flow in you as breathing. Let the pure breathing happen in your nadis. Pure breathing without thinking. Pure breathing without thoughts. Let the time stand still. Yeah. यम यम Pure breathing without thinking. No sound. Any physical movement is okay, but don't allow sound, because through sound the energy will leave your body. Physical movements are okay. No sound. Pure breathing without thoughts. I bless you all to achieve, experience, live, express, radiate and share the eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.